Most kind and love and merciful Father in heaven. By the power of the Holy Melchizedek priesthood, and in the name of Jesus Christ, I dedicate and consecrate this burial plot, this site, for the resting place of our beloved Bradford Earl McPherson, and pray that this sacred place may be hallowed and protected until the morning of the first resurrection. Father, we pray for our beloved father, husband, brother, son, friend to all, that his spirit is with thee and that he has fulfilled his mission here upon this earth. We know, and it will be said, that the world is a better place because he has lived in it. And we are happy in that he is victorious over this life, that he has proved himself faithful and worthy to return back to thy presence and into the arms of our loving Savior. Father, we pray that thou will bless us, that we may follow his example, that we may give a soft answer, that we may not speak ill of no one, and that we may be kind to others, regardless of their station in life, and that we may go about quietly serving others. Thus, we will be continuing to do thy work here upon this earth. We're so grateful for the plan of salvation, for the atonement of our Savior, and for the gift of resurrection, that we one day may be able to feel his embrace again, and also that we may kneel and bow before thy Son and acknowledge him, that he is our Redeemer and our Savior. We pray and ask a special blessing that this place may be special, and that in times of need that we as family member and friends may come and honor him and be able to let him know of our love for him, that his memory will never be forgotten, and that it will always be within our hearts. Father, we pray that thou will bless his special sweetheart and our mother in the coming days and weeks ahead, that she may be able to feel peace in her heart, recognizing that thou art in control, and that all things happen for a purpose. What purpose we do not know at this time, but one day we may understand. And that mom may have special moments in which she may be able to feel the love of our Father, and that she may be able to know that he is okay, and that all is well, and that she may always feel close to him. We bless her with strength through the power of the Savior, that she may go forward with her life and continue what Dad and her did, that she may continue to serve, and that she may continue to bless others and lift them up. And as she does, she may feel a power and a peace come over her, that she may know that for every service act, she's coming closer to her Savior. We pray that thou bless Brad's family, his friends and associates, in the coming years ahead, that they may never forget him, that he may always live in our hearts, and that we may know that he's doing a greater work on the other side of the veil, and that he has entrusted us to continue the legacy of following Christ, and to be serving him, and to do whatever it takes, no matter how painful, how difficult it may be, but to be selfless and to go forward in building the kingdom of God here on this earth. And these things we pray and bless, that thou will watch over my dad until we meet again. In the name of Jesus Christ, amen.
Nous vivons.
That will conclude the services for Brother Brad McPherson. We do have a meal being provided by the Word of Relief Society for the family back in the church. And if you'd like to come and visit the gravesite, they'll have that ready in approximately an hour. So thank you all.
Imelda, my heart goes out to you. I want you to know how much I love you with all of my heart and soul. We missed you this day. We pray for you. We love you very, very dearly. Thank you for bringing into this world with a great man and a great son that could be all of our friends and brothers. And our love goes with you. All of my family love is with you, Imelda. Thank you. Let us know what we can do and tell us if we can help you. There's a secret I can share. I've been learning about saying the past 2 or 3 years that you should just try to do this. I know how to get there.